Alright, so today I guess I'm going to return to this the eco subdivides. Now, we're looking at opportunity, we're looking at elderly people, we're thinking, well, maybe this is a good opportunity as another option because many can't afford these expensive, or what they call them, rest homes or blah blah blah. So it would be a good alternative if you live with your daughter or your son, and they care for you. It's another option that takes a lot of burden away from them. So you have these little formations of 10 or 20 houses. They're making their eco community, and off maybe once a day, you know, there can be like a communal food area for these seniors. And so they for sure have balanced meals and blah blah blah, because you already know the burden placed upon that child that ends up, you know, caring for the parent. So that would be, instead of just one child, there would be maybe 10 of those children would have, you know, occasional kitchen duties, you know, for the others. And so it would be a lot of help. It would be a lot of help, because as time goes on and time progresses, you know, you have these people that are out there, you know, feeding their parents and you know, relying on the meal on a wheel or whatever. And it just seems like a really kind of a nice and end of life situation also. Because they would be really sent out to pasture, literally. They could have animals like a horse or a cow. They can have chickens, and they can have all of these things, and they could help. You know, these older people could help. They could help with the community. They could help build pathways. They could help with the parks, aside from their own little property. I know they don't do a lot. But they can still pick up twigs, you know, they can pick up twigs for thatched roofs. So in this way, the elderly person is not, you know, just pushed out to some rest home and just like, you know, shoved into a chair and just like, well, just watch TV, that's our TV time, and then you eat lunch at, you know, because the life just becomes I don't know, like a why bother wheel. And much better to have that elderly person actually providing in some manner. When I say providing, if they're out there picking up twigs like they used to, just like the old adage, and you know, you have that man or that woman with the twigs on their back, you know, like carrying them, you know, every day, their collection. That's just the old way it was done. And they live very, very good lives, long, long, long years. You know, I've met people that are very, very old, and they work on a garden, and I mean really seriously work on a garden. And I don't see that going along on a lot here in the United States. I don't see the elder people doing that. I see them being pushed off into these centers and these, you know. Everybody's saying they have Alzheimer's or whatever. Instead of, you know, maybe that's all they have to do each day is go and gather the eggs from the chickens. You know, that's it. Very simple. There's nothing wrong with that. So yeah, when you're talking about bringing you know, the hype work down, because they've been hype worked out their whole lives. There's that hype work that they still actually like to commit to. They like to do that little bit. And that gives them a reason still, rather than just watching videos or TV. Okay. Yeah, they just, you know, their minds just become simpler demands, yes, but simpler happinesses show up. You know, that those types of things are simpler happinesses. And yeah, so maybe that kind of a deal. So as you get like 10 or 20 of what do you call these people? What do you call us? Well, I hate the word care. Well, a caregiver, I guess, the caregiver children. So you have the caregiver children with some kind of a community kitchen environment where things can be baked for them. That's it, you know, baked or you know, have a meal, a real good meal ever so often. And that type of thing, and yet also be in that rural environment where there could be a park system with animals, horses to feed. Ooh, exciting. Horses are very exciting for older people. Very exciting. And then there's the, you know, cows. You know, even if they don't milk, or if they have goats or whatever and they don't milk, they can still help feed them. So yeah, they're not needing to be completely diminished into a zero state, you know, for the last 10 years of their lives, as to what's going on now here in the United States with all of these elderly people centers. Yeah. So they can still, you know, do things. Even get in there and shovel out some of their cages. They like to. They like to participate. And this is my I Spy. I've been here in this area here on the coast, Pacifica region, and I've been to that community center, the senior center, again and again and again, and they're just like, I don't know, that's their pasture area, and it's not cool. I'm not enjoying it. I just think it's become a fester of what? You know, of what? Just waste. Wasted humans. When they still can, they can still get up and walk. They still can do things, you know, that make them satisfied at the end of the day. People are satisfied to do things. And, yeah. Anyway, so that would be a good design for certain people and that are in extreme situations with their elderly parents. Okay? So, yeah, we have to think about those types of eco-villages being very, very important. Okay? And yeah, even if it includes natural cremation services, well, those types of things also. I don't know the legalities of that here in America. Maybe you're not allowed to, but yeah, the whole full circle